How's it going, YouTube? Hope you're having a great week. Hope everything's going well. It's Memorial Weekend, so I do have a challenge for you before we start tonight. Okay, and that challenge is that maybe you're not going to church this weekend because you're a little bit away from it, you're with family or whatever else. I challenge you, take some time, just you or whoever wants to be involved, right? That needs this, or wants this, I should say. And spend some time in the Word, and spend some time talking to God, right? And just, you know, communicate with Him. A lot of times when we have a long weekend, we have some relaxing time. Relax in God's presence, right? And that's my challenge, not only to you, but to me too, okay? So this week we're gonna call it Me Too. Go figure, right? And we're gonna read from Galatians 6, 1 through 3. And before we read this, have you ever been on social media or been around family for the holidays or been around friends or been around, you know, maybe you're just in a restaurant or something like that, right? Maybe you're in church or maybe you're not in church and you see somebody that you recognize from church and maybe they're doing stuff that is not right, you know? Maybe they're, you know, drinking and falling, stumbling out of a restaurant. Maybe they're, you know, committing sexual sins. Maybe they're, you know, who knows? Maybe they're just putting God second in their life, right? You think it's not easy, but it's so easy to do that one. You know, we get so busy in our life and we get so caught up in the things going on that we forget about Him, right? It's something we should strive hard to not to do, but we do. I do it. We all do it, right? Or maybe you see something posted on social media and you're like, man, you know? And your first reaction is to go out and, you know, just grab them and say, what in the heck are you doing? You know, what are you thinking? You're wrong. You're this, you're that, you're a sinner, whatever it might be. What the, you know, and just beat them and say, tough love, let's get on the right path, right? Well, that's not what God asked us to do, right? And in Galatians 6, 1 through 3, it says, brethren, if a man is overtaken in any trespass, you who are spiritual, restore such a one in a spirit of gentleness. Consider yourself, lest you also be tempted. Bear one another's burdens, and so fulfill the law of Christ. The law of Christ would be, you know, love the Lord your God, love your neighbor as yourself. The law of love, whatever you want to call it, right? For if anyone thinks himself to be something, when he is nothing, he deceives himself, right? Let's start with the end, right? If we sit there and we think, hey man, I can't fall into that sin, we deceive ourselves. There is no sin that we aren't capable of. We think there is. You know, we say, oh, I can, you know. But somehow, backwards, roundabout, our sin nature gets us stuck into it. And we're like, how in the heck did I get here? Well, you got yourself there. That's the truth, right? But how does God say to restore someone, right? He says in spirit of gentleness. The Christ law says, love the Lord your God. Love your neighbor as yourself, right? If you love your neighbor as yourself, okay, then how would you want to be restored if you were doing something wrong? Would you want someone to come and beat you upside the head with a bat and show you some tough love? Or maybe, you know, maybe you'd want them to come up and say, hey, you know, I don't know what you're going through. If you want to talk about it, fine. If not, that's fine. I just want to be here for you. I want to be your friend. I want to love you. And that's it. You know, no judging, no nothing, right? You ain't got to tell me. I just want to be here for you, okay? That's what God wants us to do. He wants these people to be restored. He doesn't want them to be lost forever. He doesn't give up on you, and He doesn't want to give up on them. He doesn't want you to give up on them, okay? And more than that, if we sit there and we think, you know, okay, I got to meet them where they're at. Well, don't fall into their sin by meeting them where they're at, you know, either. I mean, we ain't got to go sin just to be friends with them. Like I said, maybe they're out drinking or something like that and getting wasted or doing something, you know, sexual sin or some other, you know, maybe they're just putting God second in their life. It doesn't say, hey, go put God second in your life so you can you know, relate to this person. Go commit this sexual sin so you can relate to this person. Go, you know, go out and get wasted so you can, you know, connect with this person. And that way you restore him with gentle. No. It says love them. And loving them is not doing the same thing. It's being a friend. Caring about them, right? You know, a lot of times we think, you know, man, this person, if they just understood, they would stop doing this. Have you ever been addicted to something? I know I was, you know, I used to smoke cigarettes and other things. And thankfully, I don't no more, right? But there was many times that I would sit there and I would take and I tried to quit. I quit for 6-8 months and I'd just go around it. And before you know it, oh, you want a cigarette? Okay, sure, yeah, I'll just have one. Because I'm okay, I'm already past this, right? One cigarette, at least two, at least three. I'm back stuck in it before I know, right? And I'm sitting there and finally, one year I just said, you know what, I give up. I'm just going to die of lung cancer. There's no way I can beat this. I've tried so hard, you know? And I prayed and I did everything else, right? And finally, God helped me. I mean, not finally. Finally, I listened and I accepted his help, right? And it took a lot of time. It wasn't easy. And I know if I went out and did it again, I'd be stuck back in the same place. It's the same with people, right? A lot of times they don't want to be there. They don't want to be in the sin or that sin, the shame of it, or, you know, whatever it might be, right? They don't want to be there. Beating them upside the head doesn't help that. But maybe being a friend. You know, maybe they're having a hard time with life. Maybe they don't feel like anybody really cares about them. And so they turn to this stuff, these sins, to fulfill that hole that they got, feel like they got, right? When they could just fill it with God, but you know what? They're too blinded to see it. They're too stuck in their sin. They're too sunk down. They don't need someone to come and push them further. They need someone to go up and give them a hand. Bear their burden with them. You don't got to know it, right? See, this is stuff that I struggle with, that I should do, okay? So that's my goal, and is going forward, you know, is to be restoring people in gentleness and kindness, right? I don't even know about it. I just go up and I say, hey, you know, I think you're, you know, are you having a hard time? Can I do anything for you? Can I be your friend? Can I listen? Can I just sit here, right? What can I do? Anything. I don't care. Just shut up and say nothing and, you know, be around. That's what God, restoring people in the spirit of gentleness is. So let's make that our goal. And like I said, challenge, read God's word, be spend time with him, you know? And if this is something you struggle with, maybe pray about it, right? He'll help you. It's not always going to be easy. It takes work, right? But he will help you. So if, you know, I don't do these videos for myself. If this touches you, share it. So hopefully it'll touch somebody else that might need it, right? If you know, maybe you're that person that's been beating people down and you need hair and you're wondering why it ain't working. Well, this might be why. Maybe you're that person that's been beaten down. Well, God loves you no matter what, right? And he's there for you. There ain't a sin he can't, you know, cover. Any sin is the same as any other sin. It doesn't look any different to God. Because all it comes down to is we all need a Savior. We've all fallen short, right? And if that's you and you want a Savior, comment. I'll tell you how, if you don't know. Go to church, find somebody that loves God, that reads his word, and that wants you to see heaven and spend heaven with you. And ask them how to be saved, right? Or ask me, like I said. That's why I do this, and that's the only reason. Have a great week. Have a great weekend. Spend time with God. Spend time with family. And just be reinvigorated, hopefully.